everyone. We have done in some earlier sessions some themes around yamas and niyamas written about in the Yoga Sutra by Patanjali thousands of years ago. We talked about ahimsa and non-harming, and we also talked about santosha, contentment. Today I want to talk about the second yama, which is satya, translated as truthfulness or honesty. And although that's the direct translation, there's more to it. I know that when people think of truthfulness or honesty, they just think of not lying. And I'm hoping that most people watching this video know that generally trying not to tell lies is a good idea. But it's not always that simple, right? Real honesty and truthfulness is actually about being true to your own values, to what's in your heart, to what's real and honest for you, and being true to yourself. Sometimes that means going against the norm, sometimes that means living differently than what's expected of you, and setting new paths, and finding new ways. Mostly it's about being honest with yourself. Where are you deluding yourself? Where are you being dishonest with yourself? And how can we remedy that? So we're going to practice that with our physical practice today. If you feel yourself being dishonest with what you're capable of, cutting yourself short and cheating yourself, I want you to just be conscious of that. If you feel yourself lying to yourself about the fact that you actually need a break and need to cut back and start harming yourself, I want you to be honest with that. I want you to be observant of your thoughts. If you start having a lot of negative thoughts that are not true to what you actually think and feel, simply because you're exerting effort, I want you to be conscious of that too, right? It's a daily practice, finding what's true in our hearts and embodying that in reality, even in the world that's often dishonest to us, right? It's up to us to be better people and to be the next evolutionary step forward. So with that, we're going to start with some calming breaths. I want you to just find a gentle seat. Take a moment to settle into the earth, to realize that you're here. You've made it to another one of your glorious practices. So I can hear my neighbors in the background doing some lawn mowing. So we're going to try and be noisier than them and do some knees breath. I want you to tilt your chin towards your chest. And we'll make three very, very nice, deep, resonating V's breaths. And let me hear you in your chest voice. So inhale. Some truths of honesty. As you feel those tones resonating in your body, we'll try middle range now, speaking voice, your throat voice, where your real true speaking comes from. Inhale. Tilt your head towards the glorious sky, and I want three more nice and high resonating in your temples like a bumblebee on helium. We have humbled and quieted the lawnmower with the sincerity of our breathing. So, let's start moving our bodies. Everyone, up on your feet. We'll start with some sun salutations. As you know, we've done many, many variations of this, but there's only a small fraction of what there is available to us, the different variations that are
on there. Feel free to make up your own. Do any of the earlier ones we've done. Feel free to just do the basic one. Always feel free to just take the half sun salutation and not come down to the floor. If you're following me today, we're going to do the sun V, or Namaskar V, because it is a practice in integrity and balance and in muscle control. Because we're going to be coming into a high lunge, which takes some balance control. It's going to help us focus and be honest with ourselves. So inhale, exhale out. Inhale, halfway lift, lat back, shoulders away from ears. Exhale, fold forward, come into your down dog. Take your right foot up towards the sky. As you take it between your hands, come up for a high lunge and do not move in that back foot like you would in a warrior one. So, a chance to practice satya, truthfulness, and straight elbows. Are your arms straight? Shoulders relaxed down your back. Are you tensing your face or neck? Be honest with yourself about that. Keep breathing. Do not hold your breath. Don't cheat yourself here with oxygen. Exhale down. Come into your down dog. Take your left leg up. Point it towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Take it between your hands. Come on up with control, with truth. Exhale down. Come into your down dog. Come into your plank. So notice if you had to move your hands or feet to come into plank. Proper down dog position should have hands and feet the same distance they are in plank. Now you can lower down knees, chest, and chin, or come down into a chaturanga. Just don't go down past your elbows. Again, be honest with yourself there. Inhale, open your heart. Come up for an up dog. Tuck those toes. Raise those hips, down dog. Now, you can walk your feet to your hands or do a little jump. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, shoulders away from ears, long neck. Exhale down. Inhale, rise up. Bring your hands to that beautiful beating heart, that real source of truth, of honesty, what's in your heart. Not what's in your brain, not what society's telling you. What's in your heart? What is your heart telling you? That embodied in you. Let's do another one of these. Inhale, exhale down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward, come into your down dog. Take that right foot up towards the sky. Take it between your hands, come on up for a high lunge. Exhale down, come into your down dog. Take that left leg up. Take it between your hands. Inhale, open up. Exhale, down. Come in here, down dog. Take your way into a plank. Come on down. Inhale, open up. Tuck those toes. Raise those hips. Down dog. Good. You can hop to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, rise up. Remember, honesty doesn't mean perfection. Playful and laughing, even when you fall out a little bit. Let's do this again. Last time, one breath per movement. Inhale, open up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. Come into your down dog. Take that right leg up towards the sky. Take it between your hands. Come on up. Exhale, down. Find your down dog. Take that left leg up. Take it between your hands. Reach up, high lunge. Open your heart towards the sky. Be brave, be proud. Exhale down. Come into your down dog. Take your plank. Lower down your favorite way and open up your heart. Be brave enough to be true to your heart, to be honest. Tuck your toes. Come into your down dog. Jump to your hands or walk. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, rise up. Feel your heartbeat. It takes courage, to be honest, what's true in your heart. So find that courage right now. Find that strength and know that you're not alone. We're all in this together, trying to move things forward in the world. We have had some beautiful rain last night. So let's do our little rain dance. You know, we gotta honor the rain because it cleanses us, it washes things out, it purifies the world, and it makes my garden happy. Keep going. So with that rain came some lovely thunder and lightning. So let's come into lightning pose. Our high lunges earlier were practice for this. Flex your hands behind you. I want bolts of lightning coming out of your fingers. Active hands. Really engage your triceps here. Open up your heart, your chest. This is a heart chest opener. It's also really intense arm exercise and leg exercise. I want energy coming out of your fingertips. You can even make some lightning sounds if you want. Alright, ready? We're coming from here into a warrior three. This is a difficult balancing, so if you need to find a wall, do that. Be honest with yourself, right? Be true to who you are and to your body and its needs. And when you find a good spot, if I take a look at it's not moving, and make a little L. My more advanced students can try coming from here into a standing split. Come out with control. Stand Tadasana. Be a proud, brave mountain. True and unmoving. Honest. Alright. You gotta be bolts of lightning on the other side. Energy coming out of your fingertips. Really active hands, okay? I want beams of light shining from your fingers. When you're ready, you can again grab the wall if you need. Coming into our warrior three. A nice, brave, proud warrior. Perfect L, as good as you can get it. And those of you who want to try taking this a step further, find standing stance. And then come out with control. Beautiful. Let's take a goddess stance. You can come up onto your tippy toes if you want. Be brave, be proud. Remember, this is named after the goddess Kyra, the goddess of destruction and evil. She was eating up the planet until the god Shiva of consciousness and enlightenment laid at her feet and humbled her. As I said before, we could use a little bit of that right now, so come on out. Ah, should feel good to straighten your legs. I want you to interweave your fingers the opposite intuitive way. Whatever thumb wants to be on top, try it the other way. Be honest with yourself. Practice truthfulness. Inhale and exhale, fold forward into a deep forward. Take your hands to your hips. Slowly rise up with a nice flat back. Good. And find a seat. Take one leg over the other. Elbow to knee. Find a nice little twist. We haven't done almost any twisting yet today. So let's just wring out the spine. Wring out any toxins, anything that's not serving us. Perhaps some illusions that we're holding on to. Some lies that we're telling ourselves or others that we just can't quite let go of. This is the moment. Wring it out. Just let it cleanse out of your body, just like the rain cleansed the air. Okay, we're coming to the other side. You can just switch legs. Or if you want to join me in my fun little party trick, take your arms around, do a sweet little loop-de-loop. Voila! And take it to the other side. Good. Remember, shoulders away from ears. Long neck. Find some integrity here, some honesty. And find your way onto your back. We're going to take a hip stretch, a little thread the needle. Remember, this is my alternative to pigeon, so in other videos or other classes you may take, if a teacher calls for pigeon, this is a beautiful alternative. It's the same hip stretch, just a little easier on your knees. So you're going to take your ankle to your thigh, weave your hands through and pull this towards you. Flex this foot to protect your knee and pull it towards you. And breathe. The azaleas behind me smell so good. And so does the clean air after the rain, washing away all the pollutions. So we're now going to take this into a twist. So I want you to simply take this whole crazy wide-legged shape, take it over into a little twist and look over that opposite hand. Good, come back to center and take a moment to shake it out. You can draw little circles on the sky or ceiling with your knees. Let's take it the other way, flex this foot, think ankle to shin, pull it towards you. Breathe. Good. And take it the other way. Look over the opposite hand. Nice work. Draw little circles on the ceiling with your knees one direction and then the other. Lift your feet up towards the sky. Flex your feet. Find a little waterfall pose. Imagine beautiful water just running down your legs. You can wiggle your toes if you want. Shake out your ankles. Just enjoy how great it feels to let the energy drain the other way, right? Sometimes getting our feet above our heart is the best way to actually find truth inside ourselves and our bodies. Just let the energy and the buildup just flow the other direction. Shake things up. Last little bit of core work. Point your toes slowly. Slowly lower down and keep breathing, right? Be honest with yourself here. You can engage your core muscles and keep your breath going. So keep breathing. Nice, slow, solid breaths. We'll end with one of my favorite heart openers and back bends. We'll take a fish pose. I want your hands nice and under your hips, palms down. Come up onto your elbows, open your heart to the sky, and drop your head. We'll stay here for 12 deep, meaningful breaths. You do not have to be on my schedule, but if you have finished your 12 breaths, whenever you have, slowly come down and find your way into a Shavasana. I want feet turned out, palms up, close your eyes. Breathe. Let your breathing become natural. And let the earth support you. Let gravity hold you. I have beautiful white clouds to look at above me in the sky. If you don't have that, then just close your eyes. If you're staring at a ceiling, and picture it. Beautiful white clouds in a blue sky, just floating by slowly. You may stay here as long as you like. When you are ready, start to wiggle your fingers and toes. Wake up your nervous system gently. Give yourself a loving good morning stretch, welcoming the new you, the new honest true self you're coming into, you're becoming, you're creating. Slowly roll over into a sweet little fetal position. And take a moment to embrace this beautiful, nurturing, loving position you once started life in. When you were the most truest version of yourself, completely whole and one with everything, with no illusions to protect, no stories or lies to tell. The most honest, true, sincere, precious, strong, noble version of what you are. And with that, slowly seat yourself up. You may keep your eyes closed. Take your hands to your heart, palm over palm. And take a moment to just reflect on what's true for you. What is your truth? Maybe you don't have words for it. Maybe you don't even want to have words for it.
is just a feeling, and that's beautiful too. If it's just an impression. And let's support ourselves and each other. Even all across the country and world, the people watching this video, in our daily practice and rewarding fight to be honest and true to what's in our hearts. Take a deep inhale, we'll support ourselves with the sound of all. Take a deep inhale. Take your hands to your forehead for clear and pure thought. Take your hands to your lips for clear and pure speech. And take your hands to your heart for clear and pure intentions. Thank you for practicing and embodying Satya with me today and for being the amazing, true, genuine rays of light that you are in this cosmic background with infinite love. Namaste.